Okay, while going through my regular read, I happen to come across a great survey of LinkedIn. LinkedIn is one platform which offers a lot of job opportunity. At this point where the job markets are absolutely getting saturated, what I happen to come across was this technically driven report which serves as an MIS or a survey or a research to entire student is we this particular read talks about how the interviewer needs to prepare themselves, what all set of questions they need to ask to the interviewee, and what is that which you should see from the interviewee perspective as to how he or she can respond. So it's basically a hiring process. So quickly catching to top traits of salesperson. Ambition, look for someone who has the drive to set goals and actually achieve them. Your ideal candidate should be striving to exceed quota and meet business goals. What is integrity is successful sales employees focus on accuracy and radiate integrity. Determine whether a candidate has those traits by asking for a scenario, a case study, maybe a scene, a situation where they stood up for what they think they were right for. The third thing is adaptable or being adaptable. A sales candidate should demonstrate an aptitude for critical and flexible thinking, as well as the ability to excel in the fast-paced environment where change is inevitable. So, adaptability. Customer-centric, any question centered around process and customer management should shine a light on candidate's strategy for working with customers. Focus on how they navigate a sales scenario, how they prepare, plan, and whether they act like a strategic partner or they are just an employee. So it takes beyond thought of being customer-centric, not considering them as an employee, but also becoming part of the entrepreneurial skills required or desired from that particular candidate. Being proactive is aiming at a strong candidate who values growth opportunities. Candidates who not only provide situational examples of failure, but also reveal how they learn from it, demonstrate high emotional IQ, curiosity, and leadership potential. So these are the five different skills. And let's say if we need to take one question on each, what it would be. Ambition. For example, you can always ask this. Where do you see yourself within our organization in 5 years? So sample answer could be, in 5 years, I would like to be considered as a mentor, not just on the sales team, but throughout the organization as a whole. I'll also have taken the lead on the number of projects that helped your company succeed. I'd love to be the type of employee you benchmark future hires against. High performers should be able to list a series of accomplishments and achievements from their past, which will help them predict their future success. Look for candidates who align their goals with your organization's success and who treat this question as an exploration of ways they meet the job description. This was the first question. Let's go to the second question on integrity. Tell me about a time when you had to handle a tough problem that challenged fairness or ethical issues. What did you do? The sample answer could be a few teammates inserted language in a proposal that overstated product benefits relevant to business needs. I took steps to demonstrate why this language shouldn't be included, referencing internal product documents and even looping in product managers to get a second opinion. The decision to remove certain language wasn't welcomed by the entire team, but it was the right thing to do for the prospective client. So what are things that you need to listen to is the answer reveals the candidate's ability to solve problems in the face of adversity and actually influences the process. If the candidate doesn't present a specific experience or their scenario lacks complexity, it would be a red flag. No candidate will be perfect, but one who demonstrates that they were willing to go against popular opinion reveals their transparency and trustworthiness. This should translate to someone who values the longevity of client relationship over a short-term sale. Let's also have a question for adaptability. Tell me about a time when the policy, price structure, or product changed at the last minute and you already had a deal in the field. How did you handle such situation? And the sample answer could be, I called my contact as soon as possible to inform them of the changes, but not before I took the time to thoroughly understand the implication for the business. During the conversation, I tried to anticipate their potential concerns and presented a few different options for addressing them because I wanted to focus on the solution rather than the problem. By flagging the change early and working with the customer to find a resolution together, I was able to maintain the trust in the relationship and secure the deal. And what is that one need to listen to is an answer like this reveals a candidate who can think on their feet and shows creative problem solving to overcome challenges. Look for signs that a candidate can keep a positive attitude even under high pressure or while in a stressful situation. Adaptability. Let's go to customer-centric question. You've got a new product to sell. Walk me through your sales process. And a sample answer could be, I always begin by doing my homework. I want to know the ins and out of how the product works. This means curating product data sheets, case studies, and various resources to make sure that I am armed with the right information to share with the prospective customers. I make sure to let the customer do a lot of the talking from the start so I can get a clear picture of what they need and where they can benefit from the product before I tailor the conversation around their particular challenges. And what is that which one should listen to is, look for an answer that indicates that a candidate knows how to position themselves as a strategic consultant who helps people solve their business problems rather than just a salesperson. Moving on to the last one, as a soft skill required, how to be a proactive salesperson. Describe a time when you receive criticism or feedback from your sales manager or client. How did you react? And the sample answer could be, when I first got started in sales, I had the sales aspect of role down. But I struggled to manage my team against the high volume of leads that were in pipeline. After a review with my manager that indicated she was aware of these issues, I was determined to figure out a systematic approach to staying on top of prospecting and nurturing my book of leads. First, I defined the cadence of communication and used calendar tools to make sure I had reminders in place that allowed me to follow through on daily tasks and ensure that I had time to complete all the necessary activities to be effective in this role. And what is that one needs to listen to? Salespersons are accustomed to constant rejection, but they should be able to absorb criticism, analyze it, and take actions to constantly improve. The best candidates are the ones who want feedback so they know what they can do to improve. They ask lots of questions and are accountable for mistakes, and they also take action to remedy the situation quickly as early as possible. So these are five traits which a salesperson should necessarily possess, not only possess but have a relevance of the logic of answering question with case studies and supporting argument. If this is served, I'm very sure that those candidates who are aspiring to become sales by choice would take a very informed decision and may grow substantially very, very high. Best wishes to all.